Hello and welcome to my kitchen. We are here another day for another easy, tasty, fast recipe. And today is the turn of merluza a la Vasca, or Hake Basque Style. And this is something that my mom loved to make and we loved to eat. So here we go. What we start, I finally got hold of some fresh hake. And the first step is to pass all the pieces of hake on the flour, like this. We don't want it to be too floury, just cover a little bit, like this. And that should do, see? Let me show you, like that. Not too covered, and that should be. So the oil is now hot. I'm going to reduce a bit the heat, and we're going to fry slightly our hake, just to give you a bit of color and seal it. Anyway, once that you have browned the hake, you need to add the onions. And we fry the onions and we scrub the bottom of the pan where the flour from frying the fish has stuck. And we'll cook it until it's starting to soften. So now we'll add the garlic. And now that they have browned, we're going to add a bit of flour. And a bit of salt. We're gonna mix, and we're gonna let it fry slightly. You don't want to burn it, that's why I have it in a very low heat. I'm going to add a little bit more flour. Now we're going to let it cook a bit. Well, as you can see, the sauce is getting a bit of a consistency and a bit of a color. And what we're going to do, we're going to add the fish. So we add it slowly, carefully, so we don't break it. Shouldn't break, but you never know. This is a delicious, delicious dish. Very popular in Spain. I think, I would dare to say that all the households in Spain cook this dish at some stage. And more than once, possibly. So what we do, we don't touch the fish. We just move the pan, okay? And we let it cook for a few minutes. And from time to time, we shake the pan so the sauce will blend and will thicken. Smelling so nice, I want to eat it now, but I have to wait until it's cooked. I forgot to say that this dish is usually cooked in a terracotta pot. But obviously, because I have an induction cooker, I cannot cook with a terracotta pot. Unless any of you know of a terracotta pot that can be used on induction hobs, please let me know on the comments where can I buy it, because that would make my day. That would be amazing. I could cook these in a more authentic dish, in a more authentic way. Indeed. It's been 10, 15 minutes approximately, and the sauce is already thickening. It's smelling really, really nice. And what I'm going to do, the fish is almost cooked. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add the prawns. So I just scattered the prawns around. They are all clean. They have no heads, no peel. And I just put them around, as you see. And I'm gonna let them cook a bit. What I'm going to do, this is usually, you don't usually put these in this dish, but I had them hanging around. So I'm going to add a few of these prawns because I have them, I want to use them. I don't want them to go to waste. So don't really do any harm. They are prawns at the end of the day. This is not what you put in the dish. I just must warn you. I'm putting them because I don't want them to go to waste. So I will let them cook for a little while. So as you can see, it's getting thicker, the sauce, and the prawns are almost cooked. So what I'm going to add fresh barley. I managed to get fresh barley. Hey, you may wonder where I live, not to be able to find so many things, but I'm not gonna tell you. And we scatter it like this. Nice fresh parsley. It gives such a lovely smell and taste. It is a delight, really. Fresh parsley. Pity my plant died. It won't my plant back. Anyway, so now we are going to add the clams. And these are the only clams I could get hold of. So, as I always say, we have to make do with what we got. I'm gonna put them all over and let them cook and open and do all the things they need to do. This is the way my mom used to make it. So if anybody differs from these, remember, is my mum's recipe, and it's nice. So we wait for the clams to open, check that the prawns are properly cooked. Remember, if any clams are closed, don't attempt to open them and eat them because you will get poisoned, and we don't want that. Just leave them, eat the ones that are open. You've got plenty in there to enjoy. Here we are, my friends. Most of them have opened, some have not. Can you see that? That is delicious. So nice. And now for the last touch, we are going to decorate it. Now, this is how my mum would decorate it. She would put asparagus one side, asparagus the other side, asparagus here, asparagus over there. And then she would decorate with the egg that we have cut in quarters, and she would do something like this. Just try to make it pretty. You don't have to use all the egg. She would do that. And the last one, she would put it in the middle. And that's what it is. Let's put the bits of yolk all over too. And this is, my friends, it's a winning dish. It's a Christmas dish, it's a party dish, it's a weekend dish, it's a daytime dish, it's a weekday dish, it's a dish for any occasions, and will always be tasty. So Remember, give us a like, thumbs up, subscribe for tasty recipes, and share the love for food. Share this marvelous dish. Why would you miss out on that? So, thank you very much for watching till the end, and we'll see you on the next video. Thanks. Bye.